Sunday school. Ababuye Juet, Yasulu Fellow, come forward. Then after that, Zululanda Labam Kanyan Labana was in Muba. Avantana Wunga Bashishabu Pambi. Avantana, come quicker. So was the one as can say to so was one by Scott. Shashana Avantana is a name in Nanonga. Then Zorichella to Kilavan, Holanda Laban, Holanda Laban.
Amen.
Very good. Very short duet.
When I am down and all my soul so weary, when troubles come.
tuana ngena skati ne.
Marvelous in my heart, precious in my soul. What the Lord has done for me is it marvelous in my heart.
And receive you unto me, unto myself. John 14 verse 3.
Amen. Isso é tudo só agora, né? Siyabonga. Junior 1. Right. Kosana.
Benefits of godly wisdom. Proverbs 3 verse 1 to 35. Lesson 277. Junior course number verse. My son, forget not my law, but let thine heart keep my commandments.
Amen.
Siyabonga moyo. Then asinge isinge no senior. One for senior. All right. Good. Siyabonga. Ngiyabonga.
Themba kuJehova ngenhliziyo yakho yonke. Unganyiki ngengqondo. Isabelelo 3 verse 5.
Amen. Siyabonga. Isifundo zethu se-junior and the senior and the elementary. Elementary bazophumela ngaphandle. Junior and the senior so sawuhlanganela ngaphakathi. Siyabonga. Kube nomfundo okuhle. UNkulunkulu anibusise.
Please pray for the Sunday school. Masikulekeleni the Sunday school. Pray for me. Thandazele. I'm not before you because I know better.
Akekho phambi kwenu ngoba esazi.
I'm not worthy to be in front of you.
Akafanelanga ukuba phambi kwenu.
Pray for the interpreter.
Thandazele umhlalutshi.
We all need the Spirit of God to take over this Sunday school.
Sonke sidinga umoya kaNkulunkulu ukuthi uthabathe inxaxheba kule Sunday school.
May God help us.
Amen.
We are learning about the benefits of godly wisdom.
Sifunda ngenzuzo kaNkulunkulu, ukuhlakana phakho kaNkulunkulu uNkulunkulu.
What did we learn about last week?
Sifunde ngani kuveke phele?
Our lesson last week,
Sister Nalima.
The wisdom of God. What did we say the wisdom of God is?
Singathi intoni ukuhlakana phakho kaThixo?
What is the wisdom?
Ntoni itlaganipho. The wisdom we learned about last week. Itlaganipho sifunde ngayo kufike phelileyo.
We learned that the wisdom of God makes a man to depart from evil and follow God.
Amen. What is the wisdom? What is wisdom? Ntoni
umhlakanipho.
Amen. There's one answer that I'm looking for. All the answers are correct.
The fear of the Lord.
Amen. The fear of the Lord is the wisdom. And understanding is to depart from iniquity.
Amen.
Depart from evil is understanding.
Amen.
You can have the knowledge, but if you are not going to use the knowledge, it's nothing. It benefits you nothing. To show that you have a knowledge, you must depart from iniquity.
God
shows that we have understanding.
There
are people who went to the university and studied theology. They will take this Bible and sit down with you and start arguing with you as a Christian. To have theology degree does not make you a wise person. But to have to fear God, that is the wisdom.
Amen.
That will take us through to heaven. Let's read verse 1 from our scripture. Proverbs 3, verse 135, that's our text for our lesson. Let's read Proverbs chapter 3, let's write verse 1, verse 3, and 21. Let's read in Zulu and English.
Sifunda sethu sifunda kumizekeliso chapter 3, from verse 1 to 35.
Verse 1. My son, forget not my law, but let thy heart keep my commandments. 2. For length of days and long life and peace shall they add to thee.
Verse 3 and 21.
Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about thy neck. Write them upon the table of thy heart.
21.
Verse 21. My son, let not them depart from thy eyes. Keep sound wisdom and discretion.
Amen. Zulu. Amen. My son, forget not my law, but let thine heart keep my commandments. Have having the wisdom that we heard about last week, now we have to use that wisdom. Keeping God's commandments is using the wisdom of God. Here, the writer is telling us, is telling or advising the son not to forget the law. He's saying, forget not my law.
Yeah.
Which means he has taught that son his law. Because he cannot say, my son, forget not my law if you haven't taught him.
So a father reminds
his son not to forget the law of God. We know that the law that he has taught him is the law of God.
God.
Siyazi ukuba lomthetho akamfundise wona ngomthetho kaThixo.
Because we know that the children of Israel were commanded to teach their children the law of God.
Siyazi ukuthi abantwana bakaIsrayeli baxelelwa ukuthi bafundise abantwana babo imithetho kaThixo.
They were supposed to teach them day and night, and they were supposed to make them visible.
Babefanele babafundise ubusuku nemini kwaye kwakufanele ukuthi bayenze nemithetho ibonakale.
Let's read Deuteronomy 4. Deuteronomy 4, verse 5. Let's read in Zulu.
Deuteronomy 4.
Verse 5. Bega, nilifundisile imithetho nakwabanje ngokuyala kukaJehova uThixo ukuba nikwenze lokhu ezweni eniya kuyo ukulifuya.
Amen.
Deuteronomy 6, verse 12.
Hlakaniphani-ke ningakhohlwa uJehova onifikileyo ezweni laseGibhithe endlini yobugqili.
Amen. 8, verse 11.
Qaphelani ukuba qaphela ukuba ungakhohlwa uJehova uThixo wakho ngokuzigcina izimemezelo zakhe nokwahlula kwakhe nemithetho yakhe engikuyala ngayo namuhla. 12. Funa lapho sowudlile wesutha, sowuzakhile izindlu ezinhle uhlala kuzo. 13. Nalapho imihlambo yakho yezinkomo neyezimvu seyandile, nesiliva negolide lakho seliliningi, nakho konke osekwandile, inhliziyo yakho iphakame, ukhohlwe uJehova uThixo wakho owakukhipha ezweni laseGibhithe endlini yobugqili.
Amen. They were taught to keep God's commandments. Bafundiswa ukuthi bagcine imithetho kaThixo. They were taught to teach their children as well. Bafundiswa ukuthi bafundise abantwana babo ngokunjalo.
That's why here Solomon is saying, he's reminding his son not to forget the law of God.
Yingako apho uSolomon ekhumbuza unyana wakhe ukuthi angalibali imithetho kaThixo.
Because he has taught him.
Ngokuba wayemfundisile.
As parents, do we teach our children the law of God?
Njengabazali siyabafundisa abantwana bethu imithetho kaThixo.
Can we say when they go out or to their schools, wherever they are going, my daughter, my son, don't forget the law of God.
Singatsho na xa bephumayo besiya esikolweni noma besiyaphi na sithi, ntombi yam, ungawulibali umthetho kaThixo.
Practicing wisdom is to keep God's commandments.
Ukuhlala usenza njalo ukuhlakanipha kukaThixo ukugcina umthetho kaThixo.
Whether you are a parent or you are a child, we all have to keep God's commandments.
Nokuba ngabe ungumuntu omdala ngumzali okanye ngumntwana, sonke sifanele ukugcina imithetho kaThixo.
We are learning about the benefits of godly wisdom today.
Sifunda namhlanje ngenzuzo yokuhlakanipha kukaNkulunkulu.
And we want to reap the benefits if we don't, or we are not using the wisdom of God.
Asizovuna inzuzo ukuba ngaba asisebenzisi ukuhlakanipha kukaThixo.
We learned from last week's lesson that to get this wisdom, one needs to be born again first.
Sifundile kwiveke ephelileyo ukuthi omunye ukuze ufumane le nhlakanipho kufanele uzalwe kabutsha kuqala.
Going to school is not going to give you the wisdom of God.
Ukuya kwakho esikolweni akuzukunika inhlakanipho kaThixo.
It is good to be educated.
Ukuhle ukufunda.
Because in this world,
kuba kulo mhlaba,
for us to get a job, we have to be educated.
Ukuze sifumane imisebenzi kufanele sifunde.
But there is a wisdom of God we need so that we can prepare for our heavenly kingdom.
Kodwa kunale nhlakanipho kaThixo esiyidingayo khona ukuze sikwazi ukulungiselela.
His wisdom is not found in education of this world.
Le nhlakanipho ayifumaneki kwimfundo yalomhlaba.
We get that wisdom through salvation.
Sifumana le nhlakanipho ngokwentsindiso.
And then from there you can use it.
Emva koko ungayisebenzisa.
Because if we don't use it, that salvation won't last.
Uba ngaba awuyisebenzisi le ntsindiso ayinawuhlala ixesha elide.
By fastening portion of the word of God to themselves, the idea was to present to them that it was to become an integral part of them. Because the children of Israel were instructed that they must even fasten stuff that has got written, that were written, the God's commandments. Even on the forehead, on some of their garments, on the doorpost, everywhere it was visible that they could see God's commandments. So it was just to make it be part of them so that they don't depart from it.
Abantwana bakaIsrayeli babeyalelwe ukuthi bawubhale nomthetho noba kwephi noba ubeke ebunzi okanye esandleni noba kuphi na khona ukuze ubonakale ube yingxenye yempilo yabo xa behamba emahlale ubonakale kukhona.
But we know that through Jesus Christ's death, now the laws are written in the fleshy heart, in the tables of flesh in our hearts.
Kodwa siyazi ngokusweleka kukaYesu Kristu imithetho ibhaliwe entliziyweni zethu. Enyameni emacweceni wentliziyo yethu.
Let us read Jeremiah 31, verse 33 and 34. Jeremiah 31, verse 33 and 34. Zulu.
Jeremiah 31,
verse 33 and 34.
Verse 33. Kepha lesisivumelwano engiyakusenza nendlu kaIsrayeli uJehova. Ngiyakubeka umthetho wami phakathi kwabo. Ngulobe enhlizweni yabo, ngibe uThixo wabo, babe abantu bami. 34. Abasayi kufundisana umuntu nowakhelani naye, nomuntu umfo wabo, bethi yazini uJehova. Ngokuba bayakungazi bonke, nabancinyane nabakhulu, usho uJehova. Ngokuba ngiyakuthethelela ububi babo, angisayi kukhumbula ukona kwabo.
Amen. But this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. After those days, says the Lord, I will put my law in their inward parts and write it in their hearts, and will be their God, and they shall be my people. 34. And they shall teach no more every man his neighbor, and every man his brother, saying, Know the Lord. For they shall all know me, from the least of them unto the greatest of them, saith the Lord, for I will forgive their iniquity, and I will remember their sin no more. If you are still a person who is being told, this is a sin, you don't do this, this is a sin, then there's no wisdom of God in you. There's no salvation. Seek salvation. No one is going to tell you, you don't do this, you don't do that. Because the law are written in the hearts, and you cannot sin.
Ubangaba usengulowo mntu osakhonjiswayo ukuthi le nto suyenza sisono nalesi sono usesekude nokwazi inhlakanipho kaThixo ufanele ukuthi uzalwe kabutsha. Ukuba ngaba uzelwe kabutsha akukho umuntu ozakunqanda uzakwazi ukuthi uba le nto endiyenzayo sisono uzakuxelela ukuthi le sisono akumelanga ndiyenze.
So let us teach our children the law of God.
Ngako oko masifundise abantwana bethu umthetho kaThixo.
The word of God that is being taught prayerfully to a child, that child will never forget it.
Ilizwi likaThixo elifundiswa uthandazile, lifundiswa umzali, lifundiswa umntwana wakhe, lo mntwana lowo angeke alibale.
From the early stage,
ekuqaleni kobutsha bakhe.
If you miss that, you can never recover by even teaching, by even when she can go and learn some theology when she is grown up. You will never recover the time lost or that experience that you're supposed to do to impart the word of God as a parent to your children.
Ukuba ngaba uthe umzali waphutha ukuba umfundise umntwana wakhe semncinane, libala awunawukwazi ukuthi sekemdala noba ungazama kangakanani ukugcininisa eli lizwi ukuthi malingene ngaphakathi kwakhe uzawube ephumile funda ngaphandle into ezingekho right.
So let us teach them the word of God.
Masibafundiseni ilizwi likaThixo.
Drive them to salvation.
Sibakhokhelele entsindisweni.
They will have wisdom of God.
Bazawuba nokuhlakanipha kukaThixo.
They will be able to use this sinful world to conquer the devil.
Bazokwazi ukusebenzisa ukuhlakanipha kukaThixo kulomhlaba bakwazi ukunqoba uSathane.
Let's read Hebrews 8 verse 10. Hebrews 8 verse 10.
Hebrews 8 verse 10. Kepha yilesi sivumelwano engiyakusenza nendlu kaIsrayeli ngasemva kwalezi zinsuku, isho iNkosi. Ngiyakubeka imithetho yami emzindleni kwabo, ngiyilobe ezinhliziyweni zabo. Ngiyakuba uThixo wabo, bayakuba abantu bami.
Amen. May God help us. Keeping of God's law brings length of days. Ukugcina umthetho kaThixo unikeza imihla emide yophili. Brings long life and peace. Inikeza impilo ende noxolo.
Let's read Proverbs chapter 3, verse 2. Verse 2, 25 and 26. Proverbs chapter 3.
Proverbs chapter 3, verse 2. Uzakwenzelwa kuwe ubude bezintsuku neminyaka yokuphila nenhlalo enhle.
25 and 26.
Verse 25. Ungesabi ibuso elifika masinyane nokuchitheka kwababi lapho kuzayo. Ngokuba uJehova uyakuba ithemba lakho, woligcina unyawo lwakho lungabhajwa.
Amen. Amen.
Verse 2. For length of days and long life and peace shall they add to thee. 25. Be not afraid of sudden fear, neither of desolation of the wicked when it cometh, 26. For the Lord shall be thy confidence and shall keep thy food from being taken.
Amen. Today they said to be fit and eat healthily and make sure that you stay out of the problems or the trouble. It will keep you, it will give you long life. That's what they say.
Namhlanje kuthiwa ukuba ube semandleni uqine umele udle kakuhle ukudla okuhle uzolondo leyo kwenza amajalo iza kunika ubomi obude.
But we know with the wisdom that we get from God that long life comes from God.
Kodwa thina siyazi ukuthi ngokuhlakanipha kubuya kuThixo ubomi obude ubuya kuThixo.
Comes from obeying the commandments of God.
Ibuya ekuthini sithobele imithetho kaThixo.
They are trying to do some skin surgery to make you look young for a long time.
Bayazama ukuthi bazenze ulusu babe ngoqhirha bathinje ubuso babo bajongakale bebancinci.
They are trying to use some drugs to make you look young even though you are old.
Bayazama ukusebenzisa isidakamizwa ukuthi ajongakale emncinci noba emdala.
But we know that the length of days and peace come from God.
God was yazi ukuthi ubude bempilo noxolo kubuya kuYehova.
Let's read Psalm 90 verse 10. Psalm 90 verse 10.
Psalm 90
verse 10.
Izinsuku zeminyaka yethu zineminyaka engamashumi ayisikhombisa. Noma ngenxa yamandla zineminyaka engamashumi ayisishiyagalombili. Nokho ukugcina kwayo kungokukhathazeka nokuhlupheka ngokuba kunqunywa masinyane sindize sinyamalale.
Amen. And other people say, no, these days people, there are still people who can get to 100 years. So which means that the Bible is not correct.
Kodwa abantu bazathi, hayi, kunabantu nanamhlanje abafika ekhulwini, kusho ukuthi incwadi endwele ayikho right.
Let's read in English, Psalm 90 verse 10. The days of our years are 70 years and 10. And if by reason of strength they be fourscore years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off and will fly away. Past 70 years, most of the life is full of sorrow. You are no longer strong. You can get to 100, you can get to 90, but you are no longer strong.
Ungadlula kuminyaka elishumi amashumi asixhenxe awusaqinanga emzimbeni. Udlule ukuthi amashumi asixhenxe nesibhozo awusaqinanga emzimbeni.
But the strong, peaceful days, it is said in the Bible, 70 years, and yet you can get to 80 years.
Kodwa iminyaka eqinileyo egcwe ezele ngamandla ibhaliwe apha encwadini engcwele ilishumi angamashumi asixhenxe 70 years.
But from there we know that the knees now are no longer strong.
Ukusukela apho siyazi ukuthi amadolo awasavumi.
The chores at home, you select what can I do, what I can do.
Imisebenzi nasekhaya ubamba apho naphaya.
No, you can no longer strong, stand longer.
Awusakwazi ukuma ixesha elide.
You can no longer sit down for a long time, you complain about your back.
Awukwazi nokuhlala ixesha elide phansi ukhalaza ngesinqa.
Sometimes even at night you no longer sleep well. Ngeliye kasha na sepsu kwa ulali kaku ule, struggling from insomnia. Shuncho kumunga bino tongo. Then can you say now that each 100 years the Bible is wrong?
Ngacho kutai na zaufige kulwini.
So much suffering and sorrow in that kind of life.
Ulo ntupe kwenjalo, kubo kubo kwenjalo.
So the Bible is true.
Yeah.
But we know that lengthy days with peace comes from obeying the will of God.
Kodwa siyazi imihla emide enoxolo ivela ekuthini sithobele ilizwi nemithetho kaThixo.
So let any man who desire lengthy days keep God's commandments.
Makathi omnye nomnye onqwenela imihla emide agcine imithetho
kaThixo. Anyone who desires safety,
noba ngubani onqwenela ukuthi makabe nophepha,
peace, uxolo and protection,
ukhuseleko,
let us turn and live the life that is pleasing before God.
Masiguquke siphile impilo edulisa uThixo.
And we will be even peaceful.
Sizawuba ngabanokuthula.
Happy in our old age.
Abanenjabulo abanovuyo entsukwini zethu zokukhula.
May God help us.
Amen.
Let us read Deuteronomy 5 verse 33. Deuteronomy 5 verse 33.
Ngiyakuhamba kuzo zonke izindlela eliziyalezwe uJehova uThixo wenu ukuba niphile kuze kube kuhle kini nokuba zande izinsuku zenu ezweni eniya kulifuya.
Amen.
English. Verse 33. You shall walk in all the ways which the Lord your God has commanded you, and you shall that ye may live, and that it may be well with you, and that you may prolong your days in the land in which you shall possess.
Amen. May God help us. The wisdom of God also gives us, we gain the favor even from the people we live with.
Ukuhlakanipha kukaThixo kwakhona kusinika ukuthi sibe nenceba phakathi kwabantu esihlala nabo.
There is a favor of God that He bestowed upon us by keeping the word of God.
Kunenceba uThixo ayifakayo ngaphakathi kwethu nje ngokugcina elizwi nomthetho wakhe.
Let's read Proverbs 3 verse 4.
Uyakufumana umusa nenhlanhla emehlweni kaThixo nabantu.
Amen. So shall thou find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and men.
Ubabalwe ube nengqiqo enhle emehlweni kaThixo nawabantu.
Why will you have favor in the sight of men? Maybe God, because you can say, I'm keeping God's commandment. But He also, you will have favor also before men.
Ingane kusithiwa singaba nenceba nasebantwini esihlala nabo. Mhlawumbe ungathi kuThixo ewe ngokuba ndigcine imithetho yakhe. Kodwa kuthiwa nasebantwini
fear of God.
Ukuba nokoyika uThixo,
which means you have departed from iniquity.
Usukile ebubini.
And you live the life that is pleasing before God.
Uphila impilo evuyisayo phambi kobuso bukaThixo.
Even in your workplace.
Nasemsebenzini wakho.
You will have favor before your bosses.
Uzawuba nenceba phambi kwabantu abakuphetheyo.
When they seek for one to promote, they will think about you first.
Xa becinga umuntu abanomnyusela, bazajonga wena kuqala.
Why?
Ngoba kutheni?
Because they can trust you.
Bangangokuba bangakuthemba.
They know that you are trustworthy.
Bayazi ukuthi wena uyathembakala.
They know that you will never steal.
Bayazi ukuthi awunawuba.
And you are honest.
Futhi uyathembakala unyaniseli.
That's why the wisdom of God gives us benefits of men's favor.
Yingako ukuhlakanipha kukaThixo kusinika inzuzo ebantwini.
And godly favor.
NasekuThixweni.
Even though people are sinful.
Nokuba abantu bangaba sizoni,
they still love people who are good.
Basabathanda abantu abalungileyo.
No one, even when the person is so wicked, no one will say, I want to work with a person who is not faithful.
Noba umuntu angaba ngumuntu ombi kangakanani, kodwa angeke athi ndifuna ukusebenza nomuntu ombi.
The unfaithful boss want to work with a faithful servant or employee.
Isikhulu esiphethe
msebenzini esingathembakali kodwa sifuna ukusebenza nomuntu othembakeleyo.
So you will get even the promotion that you will sit down and say, but I don't deserve this one. I think that one was supposed to be promoted.
Ngakho ke uyawufumana isinyuselo apho nawe uzawuhlala phansi ukuthi kodwa andifanelanga ukufumana isinyuselo ngenxa yokuba uThixo unawe uzasifumana.
Benefit of godly wisdom.
Inzuzo zokoyika uThixo.
May God help us.
Amen.
Let us read Daniel 1 verse 9. Daniel 1 verse 9. And Luke chapter 2 verse 52. We'll read Luke in English and Daniel 1 in Zulu.
Daniel 1
verse 9.
Daniel 1 verse 9. Uthe uThixo wabe emilile uDaniel inyuswa nokuhawukelwa emisweni lenduna yabathenwa.
Amen. Daniel had said, God has given him favor.
UThixo wayenike uDaniel inceba.
In the land of captivity.
Elizweni lezigqila.
He was one of the prime minister.
Wayengomnye wabaphezulu.
Because he was the man who feared God.
Kuba wayeyindoda eyoyika uThixo.
Luke 2 verse 52.
Verse 52. And Jesus increased them, and Jesus increased in wisdom and stature, and in favor with God and man.
Amen. He was in favor with God and man because he feared God.
Why neba uThixo nasebantwini kuba wayesoyika uThixo?
By living the holy life, we get favor before God and before men.
Ngokuphila impilo engcwele sifumana inceba phambi koThixo naphambi kwabantu.
But if we don't obey the commandments of God, we will end up saying that people hate you. Everybody hates you.
Kodwa ukuba ngaba asithobeli imithetho kaThixo kwaye asiyigcini sagqibela sesithi ake umuntu ondithandayo bonke bayandizonda.
I'm not saying by being a Christian you will be loved by all men. No.
Andithi ukuba umKristu uzathandwa nguye wonke umntu.
We know that they also hated Jesus Christ.
Siyazi ukuthi bamzonda noYesu Kristu.
But God also made favor. We give us favor before men.
God uThixo uzasenzela inceba, uzasinika inceba phambi kwabantu.
A lot of people who love Jesus so much.
Kwabona abantu abaninzi abathanda uThixo kakhulu.
That's why the Pharisees say, if we do like this, people will say this. Because they've seen the miracles that he has performed. They will turn against us.
Yingakho abaFarisi babesithi ukuba ngaba sisenza kanje, abantu bazakuthi. Uba senza kanje abantu bathi kuba babesazi ukuthi uYesu wayenze iqondiso emininzi ebantwini.
People who are following the truth will never hate you if you are a Christian.
Abantu abalandela inyaniso abasoze bakuzonde ukuba ngaba uKristu.
Christian, we live the life that is pleasing before God. Hence, even people who see us living will love us. They will love to be around us. But if we come to church every day, but not following the word of God, no one will want to be around you.
Yeah.
They even warn their children that, please, my daughter, I don't want to be closer to that child.
Masana maKristu sizoyeka uThixo abantu bayasithanda bayonqanela nokuhlala apho sikhona kodwa ubanga ba ungumntu nje oza enkonzweni kodwa engalandeli imithetho kaThixo abantu bayasuka kuwa bafuna ukuhlala kwanawe.
And those who love God and who want to live according to this word, they will never hate you if you are also obedient to the great commandments of God.
Kodwa abo abaphila ngelizwi nabo aboyika uYehova ukuba ngaba befuna ukuhlala nawe bazawuhlala nawe bangoyiki.
People will love to be around you.
Abantu bazawuthanda ukuba bakhona apho uhleli khona.
People will love to have a conversation with you.
Abantu bazawufuna ukuba nencoko nawe.
As long as you are living the life that is pleasing before God.
Oko kuba nje uphila impilo evuyisa uThixo.
God's law is a literal protection to all who embrace it.
Umthetho kaThixo usisikhuselo kuye wonke umuntu othandayo.
Let's read Proverbs 3, verse 21 to 26. Proverbs 3, verse 21 to 26.
Proverbs 3, verse 21.
Ndodana yami, wakungamubi lokho emehlweni akho. Bambelela ekululekeni nasekuqondeni 22. Koba ukuphila emphefumulweni wakho nokuhle entanyeni yakho 23. Uhamba ngethemba endleleni yakho nonyawo lwakho aliyikubeka 24. Nxa ulala phansi awuyikwesaba. Yebo, nxa ulalayo ubuthongo bakho buba mnandi 25. Ungesabi ibuso elifika masinyane nokuchitheka kwababi lapho kuzayo 26. Ngokuba uJehova uyakuba ithemba lakho olugcina unyawo lwakho ungabanjwa.
Amen. The word of God is a protection to those who embrace it.
Elizwi likaThixo lisisikhuselo kwabo abaligcinayo belithanda.
Knowing that God is my protector.
Ukwazi ukuthi uThixo ungumkhuseli wami.
Will fear nothing.
Awuzukoyika.
You will fear no death.
Awuzoyika kufa.
Fear no one.
Awuzoyika bani nami.
Because you have God.
Ngokuba unoThixo.
Why? Because you have kept his word.
Ngoba kutheni? Ngokuba ugcine izwi lakhe.
The key is on keeping God's commandments.
Undoqo ukuthi ugcine imithetho kaThixo.
The key is in keeping or living the life that is pleasing before God.
Undoqo ukuthi ugcine nokuthi uphile impilo evuyisa uThixo.
Having that you fear nothing.
Ube unako oko konke awuyiki into.
You live the life of confidence.
Uphila impilo yokuzithemba.
You know that if I want this I will have it.
Uyazi ukuthi bangifuna lezi zimane.
As long as I keep walking by God's statutes.
Oko kuba nje ndihamba ngemimiso kaThixo.
Unless if it is not the will of God for me to have it, then it's fine.
Ngaphandle kokuba akuyondana kaThixo intando kaThixo ukuthi ndingayifumani, hayi ke kulungile.
Let's read 1 Samuel 2 verse 9. 1 Samuel 2 verse 9. We benefit protection by having godly wisdom.
Sifumana isikhuselo ngokuthi sibe nokuhlakanipha kaThixo.
1 Samuel 2 verse 9, anyone? 1 Samuel 2 verse 9.
Uyakugcina izinyawo zabangcwele bakhe. Yepha ababi bayakuthula eminyameni ngokuba umuntu akayikuhlula ngamandla.
Amen. In English.
Verse 9. He will keep the feet of his saints. And the wicked shall be silent in darkness.
Amen.
For by strength shall no man prevail.
For by strength shall no man prevail.
Ngokuba ngamandla akukho umuntu unophumelela.
But Christians will keep their feet.
Kodwa amaKristu ugcina inyawo zabo.
But wicked people will not stand.
Kodwa abenzi bobubi asinakwazi ukuva.
For by strength will no man prevail.
Kuba ngamandla wethu akukho namnye umuntu onophumelela.
Can go and teach themselves how self defense classes.
Bangahamba bazifundise ukuthi ukuzikhusela kwenziwa kanjani.
But we know that God is our protector.
Kodwa siyazi ukuthi uThixo ungumkhuseli wethu.
Fight for us.
Uyasilwela.
We don't need those classes.
Asidingi ezo zikolo zokufundisa.
The class that we need is here.
Isikolo esisidingayo sesi.
Because we don't overcome by the might that we have or strength that we have.
Ngokuba asinqobi ngamandla esinawo.
In fact, we don't even fight the physical fight.
Ngakho oko asilwi ukulwa kwenyama.
God fight for us.
UThixo uyasilwela.
He protects us.
Kwaye uyasikhusela. Nanga uThixo asincede.
Let us see another next advice that we get, which is trusting in God.
Masifundene ukuthemba kuThixo.
Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5 and 6. Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5 and 6.
Verse 5. Themba kuJehova ngenhliziyo yakho yonke, ungenciki okwakho ukuqonda. Ekuhambeni kwakho konke, uvume, uyakuzilungisa izindlela zakho.
Amen. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. And lean not unto thine own understanding. 6. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path.
Amen. Kholosa ngoYehova ngenhliziyo yakho yonke, ungayami okokwakho ukuqonda. 6. Uze umazi yena ezindleleni zakho zonke, wawulungilelisa umendo wakho.
The world today has turned their back from worshiping God.
Umhlaba namhlanje.
chithele ukudumisa uThixo. They are busy baxakekile seeking happiness in the wrong places. Bafuna ukuvuya injabulo endaweni ezingekho kahle.
That's why we are living in a wicked world.
Ingakho siphila elizweni elibi.
That's why by 6 o'clock or when the sun starts to set, everybody wants their children to be at home safe.
Ingakho xa ilanga lishonayo umbethe intsimbi yesithandathu omnye nomnye ufuna umntwana wakhe abesendlini baphephe.
These days, in fact, it does not matter whether it's night or day, it is not safe out there.
Kule mihla nje akunandaba ukuthi kusemini okanye kusebusuku kubi.
They rape children,
badlwengula abantwana.
They rape older people,
badlwengula abantu abadala.
Day and night,
suku nemini.
They steal always,
bayeba njalo.
Robberies are no longer happening at night only.
Uqhekeza olwenzeka ebusuku kuphela.
They rob during the day,
baqhekeza nasemini.
They don't no longer have conscience,
abasanasazela.
But Christians,
kodwa amaKristu,
trust in the Lord,
athembela kuThixo.
With all our hearts,
ngenhliziyo zethu zonke,
and let us not lean unto our own understanding.
Kwaye singazimeli singayami okokwethu ukuqonda.
We have to put our trust, our confidence, our faith, our loyalty and hope to God.
Kufanele sibeke ithemba lethu, ukuzithemba, ukuthembakala kwethu kuThixo.
There are many who ridicule even the existence of God himself today.
Kunabanye abagxekayo badelele ukukhona kukaThixo namhlanje.
And they seek worldly pleasure.
Kwaye bafuna ubumnandi bomhlaba.
But still they live in fear.
Kodwa basaphila koyingeni.
Having so much money,
benemali engako,
but they are not in peace.
Abanako ukuthula.
They cannot sleep straight 7 hours.
Abakwazi ukulala 7 hours.
Because they always think something bad will happen to them.
Kuba njalo bahlala becinga ukuthi into embi izakwenzeka.
But those who trust in the Lord,
kodwa abo abathembele ukuthi
sleep right through.
Balala waya waya.
When you wake up is your time for prayer.
Xa uvuka lixesha lakho lokuthandaza.
And you don't even have fear of what will happen to me.
Awoyingi noba kuzakwenzeka ntoni
kuwe. Because we know that God is protecting us.
Kuba siyazi ukuba uThixo uyasikhusela.
You don't seek protection from some drugs or from some sangoma or anyway. But we know that our protection lies in God's hand.
Awufuni isikhuseli kuzidakamizwa okanye ngosiyazi, kuba siyazi ukuthi uThixo usisikhuseli sethu.
All the countries, they are crying.
Wonke umhlaba uyakhala.
Crime is too high.
Ububi buninzi.
Our governments,
abongameli bethu,
everywhere.
Kwa wonke umhlaba.
Corruption is everywhere.
Ububi bugcwele.
Why?
Kutheni?
They have forsaken worshiping God.
Bakuyekile bakuflathela ukudumisa uThixo.
They have forsaken their creator.
Bakuflathele umkhulu wabo.
Now they reap the consequences.
Ngoku bavuna iziphumo.
To ask for them to have a peaceful life, then to go back to the creator.
Ukuze babe noxolo ebomini bakho, kumele babuyele kumdali.
May God help us. Amen. Let us read Psalm 37 verse 3 and Isaiah 26 verse 3 and 4.
Verse 6. And he shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light.
Psalm 37 verse 3.
Verse 3. Trust in the Lord and do good. So shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed.
Amen. Let's read Isaiah in Zulu 26 verse 3 and 4. Isaiah 26, 3 and 4. God will direct the path of those who choose to trust him.
Isaiah 26 verse 3. Uyakumondla ngokuthula okupheleleyo, yena inhliziyo yakhe inamathele kuyena, ngokuba uyethemba kuyena. Thembani njalo njalo kuJehova, ngokuba kuJehova kukhona amandla angapheliyo.
Amen. Let's read that verse in English. Isaiah 26.
verse 3. Thou wilt keep in perfect peace, whose mind is changed on thee, because he trusted in thee.
Amen. Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed in thee, because they trust in the Lord. And when we trust in him, he will also direct our paths. Maybe there is something that is going to happen there on that way. And that day God will say, take this route. Because you trust in the Lord. You don't need a gun. Our thing is bam. But today they say if you don't have a gun, you are not safe. God understands about tomorrow about spam or paper. But a Christian lives without a gun and is always safe.
God only cries to pill up and the spam.
God directs us. Direct our physical path. He directs our spiritual path. Nothing will happen to you. Amen. If we trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord, obey his commandments. He protects us from diseases. That you are being too careful or obeying all the COVID-19
rules.
Do we think it's because I touch sanitize always? And put on the mask when we go, everywhere we go? I don't think that is enough to protect us. It is God's protection.
Amen.
We are going to shop, we are handling things there. We don't even know who touched them. Before you even sanitize, you have scratched yourself in your face or in your mouth, or you put your hands in your mouth. God who is protecting us. It is not because we are following the COVID-19 rules. It is good to follow them. But let us know that the protector is God himself. There are people who followed those rules day and night. But some were buried last week. From the same pandemic. Who am I still standing here?
I
say I'm doing enough, I'm protecting myself.
No,
it's God who's protecting us. Our children are going to school every day. They are playing sports every day. They want to play sports, they don't wear masks. As long as we keep God's commandments, as long as we live the life that is pleasing before God, we have guaranteed protection. If we direct our path, he will protect us. May God help us.
Amen.
Wisdom of this world will take us nowhere. It will only maybe give you a nice job, and even if you have that job, it is not true. There are people who got degrees, but they are sitting without a job. A Christian life is based on God's will. Based on God's will.
Amen.
Let us read verse 7 and 8 from our scripture.
Verse 7 and 8.
Mesabe uJehova udede kumubi. 8. Kuba yimpiniso emisipheni yakho nokuphumula emathanjeni akho.
26 verse 12. Proverbs 26 verse 12.
Proverbs 26 verse 12. Uyabona umuntu ohlakaniphileyo emehlweni akhe, likhona ithemba esileni kunaye.
Self-esteem and carnal security must be forsaken to obtain wisdom.
Ukuzazi kumele ushiyeke ukwenza ukuba ukwazi ukufumana ukuhlakanipha kaThixo.
A Christian who has put their trust in the Lord.
UmKristu obeka ithemba lakhe kuThixo.
Whatever we have of this world.
Noba yintoni na esinayo yalomhlaba.
Set aside.
Sibeke ecaleni.
Want to obtain godly wisdom.
Ukuba ngaba ufuna ukufumana ukuhlakanipha kaThixo.
Maybe God blessed you enough to have such a big mansion.
Mhlawumbe uThixo kusikelele waba nendlu enkulu.
And you have a security company that is the best in this country.
Unabantu abakhulu abagadile kulomhlaba.
And we have a security system that is the best one.
Une security esingundoqo
that will notify you as soon as somebody touches even the fence.
Abaza kuxelela nje wakuba umuntu ethukumisa ucingo lwakho.
If you need the wisdom of God, set that aside.
Ukuba ngaba udinga ukuhlakanipha kathi xobeka oko ecaleni.
Yes, God has blessed you to have those, but a Christian must not rely on the carnal security.
Ewe uThixo ubusisile wakusikelela ube ube nabo oko, kodwa umKristu uphila ngokuyika uThixo.
May God help us. Amen. Let us read verse 9 and 10 from chapter 3. Proverbs chapter 3.
Verse 9. Mdumise uJehova ngemfuyo yakho, nangolibo lwenzuzo yakho yonke. 10. Kothi izinyama zakho zonke zigcwale ukunini, nezicindezelo zakho ziphume iwayini elisha.
Amen. In trusting the Lord, knowing what He is doing for us, knowing that our lives are on His hands.
Sithemba uThixo sisazi ukuthi impilo yethu isezandleni zakhe.
We are expected to acknowledge God's benevolence by paying tithe.
Kumele simzukise ngokuthi sesinikeze okoshulu.
Not that He needs it.
Hayi ngokuba uyayidinga.
Just to show appreciation.
Ukubonisa ukuthi siyabonga.
And there is a blessing in that.
Kunantsikelelo apho.
Malachi 3 verse 8 to 11. We are acknowledging that you are God and you are doing enough. Something I don't deserve.
Siyavuma simvuma ukuba uThixo kwaye unako konke. Yinto ekufaneleyo ukuba uyinikeze.
That's why the author here is giving this advice to us today.
Yingakho umbhali namhlanje esinikeza le ngcebiso ukuthi sikwazi ukumzukisa.
When you say, honor the Lord with thy substance and with the first fruit of thy increase, so shall thy barns be filled with plenty, and thy presses shall burst out with new wine. Doing that, we get more results. We get more blessings. What we have, we put more of it.
Ngokwenza kanjalo sifumana inzuzo engenhla njalo uyasibusisa uyasisikelela.
Malachi 3 verse 8 to 11. Zulu only.
Malachi 3
8 to 11.
Umuntu uyakweba kuThixo yini? Nibile kimi noko nithi selile kuwe ngani na ngokweshumi nangeminikelo. 9. Nithukiwe ngesithuko ngokuba nibile kimi ninasizwe sonke. 10. Ngenisani okweshumi bonke endlini yenyango kube khona ukudla endlini yami. Ningilinge phela nalokhu kusho uJehova wamabandla. Uma ningayiki nivulela izibuko zezulu nginithelele ubusiso kuze kube ukuphela kokuningi. 11. Ngiyakuthi ngikhuze odlayo ngenxa yenu. Angiyikuqeda ukudla komhlabathi wenu. Nevini lenu aliyikuphutha endle, usho uJehova wamabandla.
Amen. The Lord is spoken.
Let us read Proverbs 3, verse 11 and 12. Verse 11 and 12.
Verse 11. My son, despise not the chastising of the Lord, neither be weary of his correction. 12. For whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth, even as a father, the son in whom he delighteth.
Amen. Zulu. 11.
11. Ndodana yami, ungakudeli ukushaywa kukaJehova, unganengwa ukukhuza kwakhe. Ngokuba uJehova uyamshaya yena amthandayo, njengalokhu uyise indodana ayithandayo.
Amen. Yes, Solomon is saying, he's advising now about the chastisement of God.
Apha uSolomon uyacebisa ngoku ngokohlwaya kukaThixo.
Whom the Lord loveth, he will chastise.
Lowo uThixo amthandayo uyamhlwaya.
Let us know that even as a parent, if my daughter is going astray, I do what? I chastise to show that I love her. If she's going astray and I do nothing, which means I don't love that child.
Masazini ngoko ukuba nawe ungumzali uba ngaba umntwana wakhe uyalahleka ngokuba umthanda uyamohlwaya kuba elahleka.
The Bible also tells us that another sign of the last days, the children will be disobedient to their parents.
Ilizwi elingcwele liyasixelela ukuthi enye yeentsuku zokugqibela iyatsho ukuthi abantwana bazaba ngabantwana abangamameliyo.
And if a man is disobedient to the parent, do we think that person can obey God?
Ukuba ngaba umntwana engamamele abazali, nicinga uba lo mntwana lowo uzawumamela uThixo?
No way.
Angeke.
So we, if we disobey God,
ukuba thina sihlonela uThixo, will chastise us. Uzawusohlwaya.
And when he does that,
xa esenza njalo,
he shows that he loves us.
Usibonisa ukuba uyasithanda.
And he wants us to get into his kingdom.
Kwaye ufuna singene kubumkanini bakhe.
That's why he say, despise not the chastising of the Lord, neither be weary of his correction.
Verse 11.
Sometimes we do something and he chastises us.
Maybe
he punishes us. Maybe it's a little bit of a sickness. Or something, take away something we had.
Mhlawumbe athabathe ukuthile esinabo
to chastise us,
ukusohlwaya.
It is because he loves us,
kungokuba uyasithanda.
Let us read Hebrews 12 verse 3.
For consider him that endured such contradiction of sinners against himself, lest he be weary and faint in your mind.
Continue.
Verse 4. He have not yet resisted unto blood, striving against sin. 5. And he have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you as unto children. My son, despise not thou the chastising of the Lord, nor faint when thou art rebuked of him.
6.
Verse 6. For whom the Lord loveth, he chastiseth, and scourgeth every son whom he receiveth. 7.
Amen. Zulu, verse 6. Hebrews 12, verse 6.
Hebrews 12, verse 6. Mokuba, inkosi iyamjezisa imthandayo, ibashaye abantwana bonke ibamkelayo.
Amen. And if he does not chastise us, which means we are not his sons,
ukuba ngaba akasohlwayi kutsho ukuthi asingabo onyana bakhe.
Whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth.
Lowo uThixo amthandayo uyamlungisa.
But if we be without chastisement, then we are not the sons.
Ukuba ngaba singaphandle kwesohlwayo, ngako ke asingabo abantwana bakhe.
A Christian is not angry to God because he had heard something from them, because it's part of punishment.
UmKristu akamqumbeli uThixo ngokuba uThixo ebambe into ethile emntwaneni wakhe.
What we do is to
go back to God and correct our mistakes.
Yes,
thank Him for that chastisement. Because He's correcting us,
He's
leading us to the right path. Because the Bible said He will direct our path. When we go astray, you'll keep us back. So that we can reach our destination. We are also being told about the value of wisdom. There are two people in our text. Solomon, who's the author of our scripture today, he was very rich. And he was a king. He had everything. Being rich as he is, obviously, even the food that he eats, was of higher value. But you find that all these things, they are vanity if we don't have the wisdom of God. Let's read Ecclesiastes 2:22-23.
Let's read in Zulu and English. Yebo inhliziyo yakhe ayiphumuli ebusuku nalokho ukuyize.
Amen. Everything is vanity. Yonke into ililize. He has tested all the beauty. Being a king and rich and full of wisdom, no one was wiser than Solomon. But he valued the wisdom of God more than all that he had. And we want again to Job. Job was very rich. But he also valued the wisdom of God. Let's read Job chapter 28. Let's read verse 12. In Zulu, because of our time.
Job 28, verse 12. Ekondo iyakuthulwa phi na? Iphi indawo yokuhlakanipha?
Verse 15 to 19. Not even any gold can be likened to the wisdom of God. Remember, these people that that we are talking about here, they were not poor people.
Masikumbule, abo bantu sitheta ngabo ababili, abo
talking about something they've experienced.
Bathetha ngento abayifundile,
rich and having everything.
Bezi sitshebi benjalo benabo bonke.
They still said all is vanity.
Basathi konke kulilizwe.
The wisdom of God is number one.
Ukuhlakanipha kukaThixo
kokuqala. The wisdom of God overpowers everything.
Ukuhlakanipha kukaThixo kogqumayo.
The wisdom of God is of much value than even gold, gold itself.
Ukuhlakanipha kukaThixo kunexabiso elikhulu ukudlula igolide uqobo.
When he ends here, Job, he said, and unto men, he said, behold, the fear of the Lord, that is wisdom. And to depart from evil is understanding. Nothing can replace that wisdom and nothing can be compared to it. Wisdom of God is of extreme value. When we go back finishing our lesson, we see being warned or being advised about the love for our neighbor.
Neighborly
goodness. If the world today can keep this word,
ukubangaba umhlaba namhlanje ungagcina elilizwi,
we won't have the crime that we have today.
Asizuba nezigebengu esinazo namhlanje.
Even not even the whole world, but if more people can live according to the word of God, we won't have to fix something.
Nokuba ayengomhlaba wonke kodwa abathile noma bakubala uma ngaba bangagcina elizwi likaThixo ngeke sibe namasela ngaphandle.
Because of neighborly goodness.
Ngenxa yokuba ngumakhelwane omhle.
Let us read Proverbs 3, verse 27 to 30.
Verse 27. Withhold not good from them to whom it is due, when it is in the power of thy hand to do it. 28. Say not unto thy neighbor, go and come again, and tomorrow I will give, when thou hast it thee. 29. Devise not evil against thy neighbor, seeing he dwelleth securely by thee. 30. Strive not with a man without cause. If he have done thee no harm.
Amen. Let's read in Zulu. Proverbs 3:27-30.
Verse 27. 29.
Amen. May God help us. Withhold not good from them to whom it is due, when it is in the power of thine hand to do it. If we can be given those who have, to those people who does not have, they are not going to break into our curse.
Still, because we have given them.
If we can learn to share what we have, what God has given us to share those who are less fortunate, they will not go out there to steal because they will have enough. Each and every person, if we can take care of our neighbors, we won't have poor people who will walk down the street begging for food. Asizuba nabantu abasweleyo abahamba becela.
And when they find that they cannot get it, they go and steal.
Xa befumanisa abo bantu ukuba abafumani.
They take our clothes by force.
Okanye bagcwile
so that they can go and sell to get food.
Ukwenzela uba bahambe bayothengisa bazothola ukutya.
May God help us. Even if our government out there.
Nokuba ugovernment wethu
eradicate the corruption.
Angazama ukuphelisa ubu.
And employ people who are supposed to be employed.
Aqasha abantu abafanele ukuqeshwa.
Won't have a prostitute out there.
Asizuba nabathengisa ngemizimba
ngaphandle. People are getting rich in a way that is illegal.
Asizuba nabantu ababazizitshebi ngendlela engafanelanga.
Because things will be shared equally.
Ngokuba izinto ziyakwehla.
Those who deserve to have them.
Ngabo abafanele
ukuzifumana. And people will be employed in a fair way.
Abantu bayoqashwa ngendlela elifanele elungileyo.
28 says, say not unto thy neighbor, go and come again, and tomorrow I will give when thou hast it by thee. Don't we do that?
Musa ukuthi kumelwane wakho hamba wabuya uze nokunika ngomso kanti
unasenzija. When your neighbor is coming seeking for your assistance, say no, I will help you tomorrow. Come tomorrow. Maybe tomorrow I'll have it. While you have it.
Ngabe senzi kanjalo umakhelwane xa engena ezocela into ethile wena uthi andinayo ndizakunika ngomso ngoku usazi uba unayo.
And your neighbor knows that you have it.
Umakhelwane uyazi uba unayo.
Wanna ask your son, my son, there is such a thing in that house. Let me just go. They went out. Just break the window. I've asked, they are not giving.
Uyawucela umntana wakhe athi mntanam ndiyazi uba nayo laa mntwana phaya kulandlu. Hamba athumele umntanakhe aqhekeze kuloo ndlu yakho ayithathe ngoba unikanga icele.
Devise not evil against thy neighbor, seeing he dwelleth securely by thee.
Musa ukuyila ububi ngommelwane wakho ehleli nawe yena ekholosini.
Strive not with a man without cause if he have done thee no harm.
Musa ukubambana nomntu kungekho nto engakuphathanga kakubi nje.
Let us read Romans 13, verse 10. Romans 13, verse 10. Romans 13, verse 10.
Kepha masekufikile okupheleleyo, khona kuza kuphela okungapheleli.
In English, Romans 13, verse 10.
Verse 10. Love worketh no ill to his neighbor. Therefore, love is fulfilling of the law.
Love worketh no ill to itself. Let's read that in Zulu. Romans 13, verse 10. If we can check, we can read the word of God. And if our world today can be the people who live according to this world, we will eradicate lots of evil in our country.
Roma 13, verse 10. Uthando alwenzi okubi wabakhelene naye. Ngakho ke uthando luyafeza umthetho.
The word of God, the wisdom of God, built a nation.
Ukuhlakanipha kukaThixo ukwazi uThixo kwakha isizwe.
It looks out for those who are less fortunate.
Lijongelela abo abangenanto abasweleyo.
That is the wisdom of God.
Ukuhlakanipha
kukaThixo. All of us can exercise this wisdom.
Ukuba sonke singenza ukuhlakanipha.
We have lots of benefits to reap.
Sinenzuzo eninzi ukuvuna.
May God help us. The last part is envy not. Envy thou not the oppressor.
Eyokugqibela ukuthi ungamveli umoya umona ungabi nomona kocindezelweyo.
Let us not envy wicked people when we see like they are blossoming.
Masingabarhaleli sibavele umona abantu abangalunganga xa bephumelele.
The Bible said they are not last. They are not going to last.
Ilizwi elingcwele lithi abanawuhlala ixesha elide.
Let's read in Zulu. 31.
Verse 31. Verse 31. Ungabi namona ngakumuntu ononya. Ungayikhethi nanye izindlela zakhe.
Verse 35.
Abahlakaniphileyo bulidla ifa lobukhosi, kanti izula zothweswa ihlazo.
Amen. Let's read the last verse in Psalm 37, verse 1 and 16. Let's read it in Zulu. 37, verse 1 and 16.
Psalm Ungazikhathazi ngabo abanabalisayo, ungabi namona ngabo abenza ububi.
16.
Okuyingcosana okulungileyo kuhle kunengcebo yababi abaningi.
English, let's read verse 16.
Verse 16. A little that a righteous man has is better than the riches of many wicked.
A riches that a righteous have is better than the riches of a wicked person. Let's read 37 to 40 in Zulu, same chapter. That's our last scriptures. 37 to 40.
37. Mark the perfect man and behold the upright, for the end of that man is peace.
Amen. Whether you have more riches, whether you have none, but mark that perfect man. The end of that person is peace.
Nokuba utshebile, nokuba ulishwebu, kodwa qaphela olungileyo ngokuba isiphelo sakhe luxolo.
But the transgressors shall be destroyed together. The end of the wicked shall be cut off. 39. But the salvation of the righteous is of the Lord. He is their strength in the time of trouble. 40. And the Lord shall help them and deliver them. He shall deliver them from the wicked and save them because they trust in him.
Amen. Zulu.
Kona upheleleyo ubone uqotho ngokuba ukuphela kwalowo muntu kukuthula. 38. Kanti abaphambekayo bayakubhujiswa kanye. Ukuphela kwababi kuyakunqunywa. 39. Kepha ukusindiswa kwabalungileyo kuvela kuJehova. Uyinqaba yabo ngesikhathi sokuhlupheka. 40. Yena uJehova uyakubasiza abakhulule. Uyakubakhulula kubo ababi abasindise ngokuba bayethemba kuye.
Amen. Let us not envy the wicked. When we see like they are blossoming, we have security in our God. Benefits of godly wisdom. We have security. We have eternal life. We have everything that we need in this world and in the world to come.
Masingabamenzeli umona abangendawo singabanqweneli xa bephumelela kulo mhlaba kuba siyazi ukuthi inzuzo yokuhlakanipha kukathixo ye ezasithatha isise kumhlaba ngaphesheya.
We have security in God.
Sinesikhuselo kuthixo.
We have protection from diseases and any other evil thing.
Sinesikhuselo kwizifo nokuba kuyintoni na.
But the wicked, they only trust in their own riches.
Kodwa abenzi bobubi bakholose kuphela kwinzuzo yabo.
They put trust in their medical aid.
Bakholose kwi-medical aid zabo.
They put trust in their security company.
Babeka ukholoso kwi-security companies.
But we have security that we pay nothing.
Kodwa sinesikhuselo singabhatali into.
What we have to do? Obey God's commandments.
Esifanele ukukwenza ukugcina
ukuthobela isizathu God.
Sithembe uThixo ophilileyo. Yanga uThixo asinceda.
I want to march.
I will come again and receive you unto myself. John 14, verse 3.
Amen.
We are learning about Jesus goes to heaven. So he was with the disciples at the Mountain of Olives. Then he was telling the disciples not to leave Jerusalem because they have to be baptized with the Holy Ghost and worship the gospel and tell people about the gospel. Then he was lifted up with the cloud. Then he disappeared there. Then they were all gazing into heaven. Then two white angels appeared and said, "Why are you gazing into heaven?" Then they say, "This manner that you left, he will come back with."
Amen.
Amen.
And then before he went, he told the disciples to stay in Jerusalem because he wanted them to be baptized with the Holy Ghost. And then he said that if you are baptized with the Holy Ghost, you can go and preach the gospel.
Amen.
Amen.
How did the disciples know Jesus was alive?
He showed himself.
He did what?
He showed himself.
Amen. Amen. What were the disciples to do first after Jesus left? The first thing they had to do.
They were not supposed to get out of Jerusalem.
Amen. Number three. What were they to do after the Holy Spirit came to live in their hearts?
To preach the gospel.
Amen. Amen. Number four. How did Jesus leave the world?
By a cloud.
Amen. Amen. And how is it going to return?
It will return by a cloud.
Amen. And what did you all learn today?
I learned that he's going to come again. So when he comes again, I must be ready and I must have the spiritual steps.
Amen.
Attach written portion of the law on their bodies. Ungani uThixo wathi ama-Israel abophelele izinto zabo imithetho yakhe eminye esandleni or ekunzini somewhere else. Why? Asifundile uThixo asifundise. Why? Yes, Lord. Simplest thing. And then the second one, what is the value of wisdom? What is the value of wisdom? Sister Masaya, Wonderful. No, you are a good student. Okay, the last one. Yeah, finally, there's be some questions sometime. What will bring long life, length of days, and peace? In the end of the time, people end long life, long days, and peace. Good. It works out in my brother.
The wisdom of God.
The wisdom. You tell me the question that you're waiting. What did my question say? Okay, correct, also right, 100% right. Right, my second review, very short. I was just going to teach them my food, sometimes there will be some questions which we have to answer. Our lesson will take up for the benefits of wisdom. Now, the keeping of law brings long life, long days, and peace. As you put it in Proverbs, Proverbs 3, 2, and 4. Proverbs 3. Will prolong our days on earth. We are going to observe this very day, regardless of what is happening on earth. All these things happening here, when I am in a imitator that Jehovah, in Israel, we are going to have length of days, long life, and peace shall be added unto you. Now this the last one, almost the last one. By trusting in God, Ukumthemba uJehova, what will be the benefits? By trusting in God, ukumthemba uJehova, what will be the benefits? How? Uthixo katufundise bamnandi kanje. Asakhumbule ukuthi ukumthemba uJehova uyakuzuzana. Yes, my daughter. You will be always be protected. Uma uqina umthetho kaJehova uhlala uvikelekile. That's our teaching for today. Now today, lava Israel bali umthetho yabo ematshela ngithi in the stones. Umoshwe pula I pull up because I want to be smack again. Right? What food was the pala? It's a food a man who's a man. Why pala? But now, in our days, today, clean up. I got some power, my Jay. abhalwa somewhere else. Abhalwa kuphi? Abhalwa e? Are you sure? Okay, ngesifunde ke. Hebrews chapter 8. Rahel, just to confirm with Namkazi Parabu in his way. Chapter 8. Rahel, chapter 8. Verse 10 to.
For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws into their mind, and write them in their hearts. And I will be to them a God, and they shall be to me a people.
I will my mother. Funda kese Zulu, that 2:10. Zulu. Amen. Our today, uNkulunkulu ubhala imithetho yakho yakhe enhlizweni zethu. Uma uphenduka ngokweqiniso weBhayibheli, ufuna ukuzala kusha, imithetho kaJehova iyabhalwa enhlizweni yakho. 11. From the least to the greatest. Uma sozele kusha, akuna muntu okufundisayo anymore. No. Imithetho kaJehova ikuphi? Isenhlizweni yakho elojiwe. Awusasabi abantu ukuthi wenzayo. No. Umthetho kaJehova sewusenhlizweni wakho. Uyakuhambisa, uyakuqondisa. It reminds you everything. 12.
For I will be merciful to their unrighteousness, and their sins and their iniquities will I remember no more.
Hallelujah. Zulu. Uma sothethele kwizono imithetho kaJehova elotshwe enhlizweni yakho. Kunevesi lapha kweHezekiya 36, verse 25-27. Masifunde bese siyabhala. Hezekiya 36. Yes.
Yes. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you. And I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you an heart of flesh.
Amen.
Verse 37.
Yes.
And I will put my spirit within you, and cause you to walk in my statutes, and you shall keep my judgments.
I will cause you to walk in my statues. Niso nenza ni hambe emthethweni yami. Awusenziwe. Cha. Ifuneka isizulu manje. 26 and 27.
Inhliziyo entsha ninika yona. Umoya
wokuhlala ufana. Awumelani. Uthi yena uJehova inhliziyo entsha ngulinika yona. Awusenzelwe. Uyangunika this new heart. Yena uThixo akunikeze yona. And then
nomoya
omusha awufake phakathi kwethu. And then he will take out the stone heart out of your flesh. Ngisuse inhliziyo entshe
kuyo inyama yenu.
Glory to God. Yes.
Ninike
inhliziyo yenyama. Yes.
Ngobelo umaya wami ngaphakathi wenu, nginihambise emithethweni, emithethweni yami, nina ngigcina izaxulelo zami.
Yes, 100%. Glory to God. That's why umuntu ozile kusha, he cannot sin. That's why kune verse 8, ozele uThixo akwazi ukwenza isono, uyasilondoloza. Umubi engenzeni? Angamthinti. Uphiwe inhliziyo entsha nomoya omusha, uThixo uyakuhambisa. You can't go to darkness anymore. No. That's why the benefits of the wisdom, healing. Masi zinomusha is very, very important. Uthi omunye nomunye wethu afune this born again. It's very, very important. Ukhonza ungazalwa kabusha, you're wasting your time. When the time comes, ukuthi abantu kumele bafithwe, angeke ufithwe wena. No, awe ufithwe. Ngoba thina othembisile ngale kuba yena umuntu. Ngiyakuthethelela isono sibube babo nokungalungi kwabo, ngiyakuthethelela. Azisho kanjalo. And I will never remember them anymore. Angiyophinda ngikhumbule. Wewe wena okhumbula izono. Why do you remember your sins and go back? Ngoba ivesi ithi, angiyi. I will never. Ayifundi. Hebrews 8, verse 11. I will not remember their sins or their iniquities anymore. I'll forgive them. Uma uthethelelwe, uthethelelwe. Abayifundela ka English sister and Zulu. Hebrews 8, yeah, 12, yeah, verse 12.
Verse 12, for I will be merciful to their unrighteousness.
I'll be merciful to the unrighteous. Ungalungi kwabo, ngiyabazwela.
And their sins and their iniquities will I remember no more.
And their sins. No movie power. I didn't have to put my foot. What they say in Sutu? Yes. 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 Yeah. That's what we do. Mouse are a bushel in town. Who might too hard on you or you are very harsh. Masiti, whosoever is born of God does not commit sin. Who might just see Ukarga Buta, Upan Banja, Umotone Kizio, Nalo Moya, Futakuha Misa. You cannot sin. And then what will happen? You have favor with God and man. You have what? Favor with God and man. God bless you. Sister Rose, keep it with your mouth. Please come forward.
This is our number 149.
Om Siddhi Siddhi Jesu Christu Kru Wego
Oh,
Amen.